Here in this one we have only one mutator method which changes the height. We assume that the name of the player will not change and the birth year will not be changed in this application. So we only have a mutator method to change the height. But in some cases, all or more attributes may be changed, so there may be more mutator methods. Here we have an accessor method for name, accessor for name attribute. The mutator methods has always the type void because they don't return anything. They get a parameter and they assign that parameter to the related attribute. So their type, the type of the mutator methods are always void. But to the contrary, in the accessor methods, their type is not void. They have the same type as the attribute that they return. Name is a string attribute, therefore the type is string. Height is integer, therefore the type of the get height is int. This is accessor for height. And let's take this one, control C. Let's go here at this, and this is B year. Okay. So I have accessor method for each attribute in this example, in this player class. Usually we have accessor methods for everything, okay? Very rarely there may be accessor, there may not be an accessor method for some attribute, but usually for every attribute there is an accessor method. Here we have accessor method for name, height, and year, and in each one it returns just the related attribute. And the accessor methods are also called get methods. And when we name an accessor method, we start with get and we concatenate the attribute to it by making the first character capital letter. Okay. So writing a mutator method and writing an accessor method are extremely easy. In accessor methods, we only have a return and name. We can put here this.name, but since there is no parameter, no other variable, this.name or name has same effect. Okay. It returns the related attribute. So we don't need to put here this.name because there is no other thing in this method called name. There's only one name, which is defined here at the beginning of the class. And usually for each class, we write a toString method, which returns a string. Here we return a string, which is made by string.format. Here we have our format. The name is placed on 24 positions. Then there is a one space after name. After 24 positions, there is a 25th position, which is left empty. Then the height is placed on three positions, and the birth year is placed on four positions. So using the name, height, and year attributes of the object, we create a string. String.format gives us a string in this format, and this toString method returns the created string. Okay, the string that is made by this is returned by the toString method. We have another object, team object here. The team object has a team name, foundation year, and the city. But the team objects will contain an array list of players. Where player is defined? Player is defined just here, okay? It is in the same file, we can write this. But when you develop a serious project, a serious software, each class is put in a separate Java source file, okay? Normally it will be something like this. I will show it from my hard disk. Let's go to Java. For example, assume that we have a person class. Here we have our person.java. For example, person.java contains a person class. In this case, there is a keyword public. so that I can use the person class and create person objects from other programs. In that case, I need to put here public. But if they are all in the same file, since the class player, the class, sorry, let's go below the class team, the team class, the player class, and the application class. Here we have our application, okay, public class, blah, blah, and our main method. They are all in the same source file. When they are in the same source file, there is no need to put here public because it's already in the same source file. Therefore, it's available to the programs in this source file. And even if I put public here, it will create some confusion and the compiler will not like it, okay? So if you put the classes and the application in the same file, here we have public class, our application, and then just a little bit below, we have our player class. Then a little bit below, we have our team class. When you do this kind of thing, you don't put public in front. But if you just write the person class, for example, or team class, or the player class in separate files, then you have to declare public because you will have to use, for example, here we have a team object, and here in the team, let's go to team. In the team class, we have a player, we have a list of player objects. So team uses player class. If I separate the team class in a different Java source file, it has to be public, and it has to use another source file which has public class player. Since this, if the player is then put in a separate class, in a separate source file, in order to be able to use it from team class, which will be in a separate source file, here I have an array list of players. I'm using the player class. It has to be public, okay? I hope this is understood. Now let's continue with this one. Here we have for our team, we have team name, foundation, sit, foundation, Iran city. Our constructor gets three parameters for each of these three attributes. But it also has a fourth line, which creates an empty array list of players. Here I have my attribute players. Of course, I forgot one thing. It has to be private. Now that's better. That's much better. If I run this and enter here, it is team.txt. It will run correctly. Okay. Now, the attributes are declared as private because of encapsulation rule. Anyway, here we have this array list. During the construction of an or creation of an object, we create also the players. This is just declaration, okay? There is nothing here yet. This is just a declaration. There is nothing yet. But here, the attribute is created and assigned. The attribute, second attribute is created and assigned. The third attribute is created and assigned. And the player's array list is created here. The constructor creates an object. Creation of an object means creation of the attributes as well, okay? Because the attributes only exist with an object. If there is no object, there is no attribute. This is just a blueprint of the attributes. In the class, we have a blueprint. When an object will be created, these four items will be created, and it is done here in the constructor. So if we have an array list of something, it will be created as an empty array list in the constructor. And for the hotel, you will do same thing. Therefore, here this room list will be similar to the players in this example. And by the way, I've shared this two classes, a underscore two underscore classes dot Java in LMS. You can download it from there. It has some similarities to your homework, and you can examine it and use it. Therefore, this array list of hotel rooms is very similar to array list of players here in this example. You will create, you will declare it something like that. Instead of player, it will be hotel room. And here it will be, for example, rooms or something like that. And rooms is equal to new array list of hotel room, blah, blah. Here we said we have a mutator method for foundation year. We assume that team name will not be changed, but foundation year might have been entered wrongly. We may have to correct it using a mutator method, set the foundation year, and the city may be set as well. But here we have get name, get foundation year, get city to get the team name, foundation year, and city attributes. Here we have several more methods. One method is to add a player to team. Okay. Here, as you see, the parameter is something of player class. Therefore, this is an object of player class, okay? We call it player. Then this player object is added to this array list. Here we have a player, and then it gets a player object, and that player object is added to the player's array list. This players is this one. Here we can write as well this. No problem with that. Maybe it is better to write here as well, although we don't need because there's no other players in this method. Therefore, the players will correspond to that array list attribute, but no problem. It is better maybe to write it like this because it will be more clear. The players array list of the team object has an add player method, which gets a player object, and that player object is added to this array list. Okay. We will create a player object from file, from this file, where it is here. From, for example, from these three lines, we will get the name of the player, the height, and the birth year of the player. We will create a player object, and then by calling the add player method, we will add that player object to the array list in the team. Here we have another method which is slightly more complicated. Here we will give just the name of a player, a string, which will contain the name of a player. It will look among the player objects in the array list of players, and when it finds that, it will remove that object. Here we have our accessor methods, as I've told you before. And we can have also something which gets the number of players. If I need to get the number of players in the team, we can call the team name, the team dot get player count, which will return the size of the array list, which is the number of players. And if I want to get a specific player giving the index of it, I can get that object, okay? Players is an array list, don't forget that. To get something from an array list, what do we use? We use the get method of the array list class. So using the index, we get one of the players from the array list. Here we have a string representation. It creates a string which contains team, concatenated with team name, cities, blah, blah, and then players. And then here we have a for loop, which uses the index variable as the index of the players array list. Here, don't forget this one, okay? We have an array list of players in the team object. And here what we do, we get every element from that array list players in the team. So when we run the two-stream method of the team, this is in the team. Let's not forget that we are in the team class yet. In the team class, our two-stream method returns something like this. Okay, team Anadolu Efes, blah, blah, blah. Everything here is returned as one string. As you see, here we have team, city, founded, blah, blah. And then backslash n to go to the next line, two space and players, next line. So this second line is made here. And then for each player, we have player.getIndex, we get a player, we put two space before it. So here there are two spaces. The player information here follows it. And then we have backslash n, a new line character after the player data. Okay. And here this is repeated for all players. So this toString method, returns a string like something like on the right hand side. Okay. This whole thing is one string which contains many backslash n's, or in other words, many new line characters. Therefore, it's a multi-line string, a string which contains multiple lines. Therefore, this toString method returns something like this on the right-hand side. And when we print that in our application program, let's go to our application program. Here we have when we want to print the team, okay? println team. What will happen? Team 1 is a team object. When we want to print something in Java using system.out.print or println, what happens if this is an object? Java automatically calls toString method of that object. Therefore, writing this line is exactly equivalent to writing team 1 dot to string, parentheses of course, because it's a method. So even if I write only this one, Java automatically calls t1.toString method to get a string representation, as you see blue highlighted on the right hand side, and this is printed. Okay, so it makes your life easier. You don't need to type toString every time. You just define toString method as it is defined here. Okay, you just write your toString method, and when you want to print that object, it will automatically call this toString method, and it will create a string and return that string. This string is returned here, and your task will be done. I mean your printing task will be done. Okay, so as I said, I can write just the object name. If I have a correct toString method, then it will automatically, Java will automatically use this as the previous statement. When I will write the system.out.println team 1, in reality, for team 1, it will call the toString method, will get a string representation of it, and print it. Because print system.out.println or system.out.print requires a string. Whether you use an object or an integer or something else, it always calls the related toString method to get a string representation of that thing. Okay, here I will modify this program. What it does, it reads the team name from a line, the year from the next line, and the city from the next line, because this program, it was written for this file, okay? Team name, year, and city, then player name, player height, birth year, second player height, and birth year, etc. Instead of using this, now I will use that one. I'll get from one line the data related with the team, and from one line separated with semicolon, the data items of what each player is on one line. So I will modify this program to read from that file. I've just copied ADA2. I want to keep the old version as well. Where it is, I have here ADA2 classes. A_2 classes. Yeah, I just copied it to java.txt file, the original version. Now I will modify this program to read from this type of file rather than that file. Okay, it is more difficult to maintain this file, but it is slightly easier to maintain this file. For each player, you just write the name, semicolon, height and semicolon, vertier, etc. It's easier to maintain this one. So what I will do, I will modify my program. Here, every time I will read a line. So I will only use next line statements. So what I will do, I will start here. The file is opened for reading. Let's call this string. I'm reading a line, okay? Line is equal to file scan.next line. Okay. Now what I did, I am reading one line from file. At the beginning, the first line that is read contains the information related with the team. All this is read. Now I want to separate this to pieces. What I will do, I will use one of the string methods. If we go to strings, let's search for split. Here we have a string method which is called split. What split does, it takes, it is used with a string dot split, and it returns an array of strings. That is made by splitting string by string by separator. What I will do, I will use this split. Now, how I will do it? It returns an array of strings. So what I will do in my program, here I will say, for example, string array data. It returns an array of strings. Therefore, I'm defining a string array. And my string is line.split. What is the concatenator, separator? It is semicolon, okay? Therefore, here, what I will get with line.split, line contains the whole line. Okay, I read the first line, which contains the name of the team, the city, and the foundation year. And I split all of them. What are my pieces? Let's go here. The first item is the team name. The second one is the foundation year. But in my class, the foundation year is integer. Let's go here. Let's go below. The foundation year is integer, okay? Therefore, I have to convert the data pieces. Here, it gives me, the split method gives me an array list of strings. Everything is a string. From this string, control C, let's copy this one. Let's create another one here. What I will get? I'll get a list of strings. Each of these will be stored as a string, okay? My data array will be an array which will contain these three strings. I have to convert this to integer. the other two are already strings, so I have no problem. Int, let's call year, is equal to, there is a function called integer dot. I have to convert what? Let's put here semicolon. The array elements start with index 0. Therefore, this will be data 0, data 1. Okay, this will be, this will have the index 1. So here I will have my data 1. I'm converting data 1 to integer. And now I have my year. I can create my team object now. What is the first one? Data 0. The second one is, let's call it F year. And the third one is data 2. Okay. Let's not forget, my line was like this. When I split the line with the split method, as on line 46 here, on the left-hand side, checked for line 46, I'm splitting the line with semicolon, which is the separator here. I get an array of three elements. Index 0 contains AnadoluEFES, index 1 contains string 1976, and the index 2 will contain this string. And using those strings, for integers and floats, I do this kind of things. For if it has to be converted to double, I will show you how to do it. Double, assume that x is equal to double dot parse double, and then data some index value. Okay, let's assume one or another thing. I'm just giving you how to do it. If you need to have something which has a double value in the file, for example, assume that it has to be there is something like if you want to convert, for example, 54 point blah 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 to a double value, but this is a string. The way to convert this string to a real double value is to use double dot parse double. Okay, this is how we convert a string to integer or a string to double. Remember the int and float methods in Python. The counterparts for that, for the int method in Python, we use integer.parseInt in Java. And to convert a double value in Python, we use float, but in Java, we use double.parseDouble. If you just remove this, you will see that it is correct. Okay. Now, from the first line that I've read, I've split the data items. I converted to integer the necessary data. Now I have all three data. Data 0 is the team name. Data 1, which is converted to F year to integer, is the second one. And this is the city is the third one. So from here, I created a team object using the data items. Here, for each player, we will again read all the player data using that. Since line is already defined here as string, I don't need to define it again. If I define it again, it will be given error because it is already declared as string here on line 45. So I don't need to declare it again on line 54. But now I have height and birth year. The name is already is already string. I have to convert the data one, and I will use the same thing again. Okay, height is, let's copy this here, and let's copy this here. Oops, sorry. But this is 2. From the file, if I check from the file, let's go here. Yeah, this one. Here again, I have on my lines the name of a player, semicolon height, semicolon birth year. So when I read this line to the lines line string object. Sorry, here on line 54, I'm in the wrong place. What is wrong? Oh, what happened here? Sometimes it does some peculiar things. This is file scan. Yeah, that's better. I don't know how it makes these kind of changes anyway. Now, the name of the player is data zero. Data one is the height. We convert it to from string to integer. Data two converts contains birth year in string. We convert it to integer, and then we don't need this statements anymore. We read everything by next line. Of course, we have to have this again. After reading the line, we have to split it, okay? Here we have that one. Maybe I can make this, anyway, let's try this. If there is something wrong, I will change the name of this player data, which is created by splitting. So here I split the line to get the data items. I convert the necessary data, which are integers here. I create a player using the data zero, which is created here, and height, which is created there, and birth year created here. I create a player name and I add that player. Now let's run this program. Enter file name. The file is this time team1.txt. As we see, the program runs correctly. I hope this is more clear. I don't know if you agree with that, but to me, having this type of file is more difficult to handle, because here you read the first line with next line, you read this one with next int, and you have to read this one with next line again. And if in a file you read something with next int or with next double, if you want to read another line with next line, you have to issue an empty next line after reading the integer. Here you can read with this with next line, next int, next int. After this next int, if you want to read this one, you have to issue after this next int an empty next line, etc. There are some technical issues, but if you have everything like this, every time you only read with next lines, you don't mix anything with next int or any other thing, but what you do, you just have a split, a string split method call to split the data items. And if there are any integer or double data items, you just use either integer parse int or double dot parse double to get the double value or integer value out of the string, and then you continue using those data items. Any questions so far related with this? Anyway, I will put this version as well. Here, enter file name. You will be expected to enter. I will just put here as a comment. Team1.txt is suitable for that. But team.txt is suitable for the other version. I'm not able to use to give you two Java programs, because in my computer, all of these Java programs are in one project, in one Eclipse project, and an Eclipse project doesn't like to have two classes with the same name. Okay, either I have to change the class name, or I have to change the class names if I want to do that. for that purpose, I don't want to have player and player two class or something like this. I have only one version of it, but I renamed my other version as java.txt file, as you see on the right hand side. This is the old version. Java is the new version. java.txt, let's open this one using open with Notepad++. Here in this one, we are using team.txt, that is used in this one, and team1.txt in the other one, because one file, team1.txt, contains semicolons, and team.txt contains each data, individual data item on a separate line, which is, to me, more difficult to maintain, and let's say this. Do you have any questions so far related to writing classes, mutator methods, accessor methods, or in particular this example? How do you handle read a line, split, convert to necessary data items, and using those data items and the created integer or double variables, create the object? And similar here, there's a second word, almost same thing. Read a line, split the line with separator, get the data items as a string array, and using this string array element, convert to necessary integer, perform the necessary integer or double conversions, store them in a variable, in variables, and using the data items, string data items in the original split data and the created variables, and create objects assigned to an object. If this object is a part of another object, team is our first object here. Okay, on line 50 we have the team object created, and every team object has, as we know, players array list. Here we have our class team and players array list. I've created the team object here, and I am creating a player, as an individual player object here, and that player object is added to the team object's player list using the add player method. Let's check the add player method again. Add player gets a player object, and that player object is added to the player's array list of the team object. Okay. Is this understood? I hope this is understood. If you have no questions, I will continue with something else. I have in my halilosman.com site data generator program. Let's generate it from this one. Let's generate, for example, 20 records of, let's say, 6 fields each, and in English. The first field, assume that this will be name field and a surname randomly generated. Assume that we want to have a year. Assume that the birth year will be something from 1980 to 1990. We will generate from 1960 to 1990. Let's generate a year between 1960 and 1990. Let's assume that this will be birth year, and assume that we will have a city for the people. Assume that we will have a profession. Each will have a profession, and assume that each will have a number of years. Not years. Let's say integer. And it is not important. This is the number of years the people are working, okay? They are started working at least 1 year, at most 10 years. So I'm generating some data here, as you see. Let's copy this. I will put this in a file, okay? I have here my person.txt. Let's remove this, put it here. Here I have first name, last name, birth year, city, profession, and how many years the person is working, okay? He is working for 1 year, this is working for 8 years, this is working for 4 years, etc. Assume that I have this kind of data. Now, I will write a class to process these persons. Assume that these are employees. Okay, I will create a class which is called employee. Employee class will have therefore how many attributes? Name, last name, birth year, city, profession, and number of work years. Therefore, there are the six attributes. Let's just copy one of the classes from here. I will just take, for example, book class, okay? Book.java. I have this class, okay? I will modify this class to have my employee class. Let's first of all save as employee.java. Employee.java. I have F name, first name. The second one is, instead of name, let's just do it more quickly. L name for the last name. The next one is, where is our persons.txt? It is this one. Let's move it here. The next one is birth year, which is an integer. So here, let's take this one, move up here. B year. The next one is city, okay? Therefore, here I have, instead of author, let's modify all authors by city. I will fix the rest later on. Next, I have some profession. Therefore, instead of genre, I will use profession. Replace all. And then the last one is number of work years. Okay, let's call it, instead of pages, I will modify this to W years for work years. Okay, so my fields or my attributes are F name, first name, L name for last name, B year for birth year, city, profession, and W years, work years. So my constructor, instead of book, of course, let's modify the book as employee. Public class employee. F name, L name, birth year, city, profession, years, work years. Employee is my constructor name. And the first one is F name. Let's fix this. F name, L name, B year, int, here we have int B year, and then city, profession, and lately we have W years, okay? F name, L name, B year, city, profession, W years. Of course, this is F name. I will replace, I will do something. Add to have it more quickly. F name is equal to F name, L name is equal to L name, city. Of course, before city, we have our birth year, B year, B year, city, profession, W years. Now I've finished my constructor. Okay. I'm constructing one object. I get all six, I get six parameters. And all six parameters are assigned to those six attributes. Now, I have here a second one. I will delete this one. Do I need to modify the first name and last name? I will assume that I won't need to modify first name, last name and birth year. But the person may change city, may change profession, and the number of work years may change. So I will write only the mutator methods for these three fields: city, profession, and work years. So mutator for city. What I will write here: set city. The string is the name of the field is city, and I will just assign to this dot city the parameter city. I have my this one profession, and I will have a mutator for profession. Of course, I will set this to capital. Set profession, string profession. Of course, this is profession. Now my second mutator is ready. My next mutator is for work years. Okay. Profession is done. Here, let's change this one. And here as well. And we put set this capital. We don't need this one. We don't need to set pages. Now let's check. Here we have our constructor, which is correct. City mutator. City, set city, 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 profession, 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 workers, 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 everything is correct. Now we have finished with mutators. We can continue with accessors, get F name, therefore this will be F name, and it will return F name, and F name is a string. This is correct. L name, get L name, L name is returned. Then what is the third one? It is the birth year. I have to have a birth year accessor method. Here I have one. I will modify this one. This will be B year. For B year, it will return B year. And of course, it will be B year. It is an integer. Now I have my accessor for birth year. Next is city. City. Get city and return city. And city string, that's correct. Next one is profession. After city, we have get profession. Of course, here we will write profession and return profession, and profession is string. That's correct. W years, work years. It returns work years, and let's put here W years. W years and returns W years, and it is integer. Therefore, our accessors are also ready. F name, F name, F name, L name, L name, L name, B year, B year, B year, city, city, city. I'll check everything. That's correct. Now I have finished my accessors as well. I want to have a string representation. Assume that I want to return a formatted string. And therefore I will remove this and remove that. I will modify this. What I will do, I will write the first name, assume that on 12 positions, minus 12s, one space, the last name on again 12 positions, minus 12s, and then the next one is birth year, B year, city, profession, and W years. Let's check the fields, F name, L name, B year, city, profession, W years. And the birth year will be on four digits, percent for D. I'm doing this just to have a well-aligned output, okay? Always the name is displayed on 12 positions. The last name is displayed on 12 positions with, of course, one space between them. And then B year on four positions. Since this is integer, I use percent %4D. City is a string. And the city will be displayed, let's assume that on 12 positions as well. I'm using 12. Hopefully there is no city name which is more longer than 12. Amsterdam is 9. Rotterdam, Barcelona, blah, blah, Budapest, 8. So there is nothing longer than New York is 8. Okay, that's okay. And I'm looking for the name to the names. Is there any name which is too long? Katrin is not more than 12 characters. No problem. But here, the profession is quite long. I will reserve some more spaces, electrical engineer, for example. Okay. So I will reserve some more spaces for the profession. And then the next one is the profession. So percent minus 20s for the profession. And work years is assume that a person can work up to 99 years. So two digits is enough. So I'm creating a string made of the fields of the object in which the first name is put on 12 positions, followed by a space, and then on 12 positions, the last name, on four digits, the birth year, on 12 positions, the city, on 20 positions, the profession, and two positions, year. Now my class, employee class is ready. Now let's write an application for that, that reads person2.txt, this file is read, and those, they are displayed on screen, okay? Now this, at this point, I will just save this one, and I will go to Eclipse. Since I've created a new profile in my directory, what I will do, I will just, in my package, refresh it, so that here somewhere I will have my employee.java, okay? I have been using Notepad++ till now to modify the employee class, but now I've opened it in Eclipse. Now let's take one of the applications which creates, which reads from file, that the last thing that we have done it, where it is the two classes. When we run it, it runs, enter file name, team1.txt was the file, okay. What I will do, I will just copy some part of it. Here we have a method which reads from file. I will use this one in employee.java. What I will do, I will just go here, just create a version of two classes.java, control C, control V, I will name it. I will say employee app. Employee application, okay? And when I created a new Java file in my project folder, I, in Eclipse, what I have to do, I have to go to default package, right click on default package, and here just refresh. When I do this, when I refresh the project, here I will see employee app.java, okay? This is now not a two classes. I just copied from this program. So it is a copy of that. I will just change this to employee app. Here, I will not read anything from keyboard. My file is known. My file name is, what is the file name? Persons2, this is my file name. I will change the file name as well. I will change to employee.txt, okay? Let me go here. But this was the person2.txt. What I will do, I will change the file name to employee.txt. Now, let's open this employee.txt once more. Now the name of the file is employee.txt. It is this file. Let's close this. Let's go here to our application. Now the file name is employee.txt. We of course, I will change the theme, the thing. Here, instead of theme, what I will do, I have many employees in the same file. So here, I will have an array list of employees. So what I will do, I will change this a little bit. I have my employee, sorry, I will create an array list employees, okay? And I will call this employees equal new, and let's copy this. Here, put parentheses for the constructor. I have my employees array list, which is empty at this time. Read employees from file. And I will call read, let's change this one. Okay. Read team is will be change with read employees. I will give the file name, and I will also give my employees array list. At the beginning, in my main program, I've created an empty array list of employee objects, and the name of the array list is employees. What I do, I call the read employees here. I give the file name as one parameter, and the second parameter is this array list. What the read employees will do, read employees will read from the file given as the first parameter, the lines, create employee objects, and store these employee objects to the employees array list. And it returns nothing, okay? As you see, I just call the method by itself. I give the file name, and I give my empty array list, and the array list will come populated with some data. I'll fix the rest in a minute. So let's first do this. Here we have in file, and also we have here an array list of employee class, and let's call it emp, okay, to make it short. I'm getting an employee array list, and the name is emp here. We are reading first line. We are splitting the line, but we will continue doing this for all lines. So what I will do, I will move these two lines to inside the loop. Why? Because I don't have any theme or something like that. I have just opened the file. As long as there are lines in the file, I will read one line for an employee. I will split the data. I will create here my employee object and add that employee object to my emp. Emp dot. Do you remember what is the method, array list method to add something? Who remembers array list method to add an object to an or array list? Anybody remembers that?
Is it set?
No. Not set is just changing for an object. Let's go to array list. Where is array lists? Okay. Add methods.
Okay.
So what we will do here, we will have just add amps. Let me change this a little bit. I will just go here. Let's call this amps for array list. And here we read a line. We split the data. Let's change these things. Let's remove this. And what are the data items? Let's go back to our file. 0 is the name, index 0, index 0 is the name, index 1 for the data items is the last name, index 2 is birth year, 3 city, 4 for the profession, and 5 for the number of work years. So I have to change 2 and 5. Okay, I have to convert the second data and the fifth data, or the in the data with index 2 and index 5. So what I will do, index 2 and index 5, this is birth year, and this is W years. Okay. So here I'm splitting the data items separated by semicolon, and in my file, they are already separated by semicolon. So my data array, string array, not array list, because split method, the split method returns an array, not array list. Okay, array lists and arrays are completely two different things. It returns an array. Array items are accessed using index, but the array list items are accessed using the get method. Okay, remember get method in the array list. Here, where is get? The get method is used to access array list objects. Set method is used to modify elements of an array list. And add method is used to add new items in an array list. But in arrays, we use indexing to access and to modify. So they are completely two different things. Here I will have an employee object. Employee, let's call it E. I will call an employee object. What are the parameters? New employee. Here we are using data 0 is the first name. Data 1 is last name. Then we have B year, and then data 3 is for the city, data 4 is for profession, and the last one is work years. Okay, here we set B year and work years from data 2 and data 5. But we don't need to modify data 0, data 1, data 3, data 4. They are already strings. And my class, my employee class, has string, string, int, string, string, int. So when I split from the file, when I split one line of the file using the semicolon as the separator, I will get 6 data items. Name as index 0, last name as index 1, birth year as index 2, city as index 3, profession as index 4, and work years, number of work years as index 5. I have to modify the year and the work years, because when we split using the split method, here, where it is, employee Java, when we split it, we get an array of strings. From the string, I need to convert it to integer, because my constructor requires integer birth year and integer work years. Okay, I have to give the correct format, correct data. That's why, of course, here there is no problem. So I have to do this conversion. Now I created an employee E. The name of the employee object is E. E is added to amps array list. And here we close the file and we finish read employees method. Now here read employees will read the file, the given file, and populate the array list. We are now ready to print the employees. Let's write here a print method. which will be private static void print employees. Let's write it. Let's put it here. Not read, but print employees. It gets an array list of employees. And here in this method, we will travel each employee and we will print it. First of all, we will print system.out.println. We will just print a header. Let's call it employees this. We will print that. And then we will get each employee in this parameter array list and we'll print it. There are two major ways of doing it. I will use the second one. I will have a for loop, an employee object, let's call E from amps. Okay. So from the amps array list, each element will be taken one by one and put into E. Since amps is an array list of employee objects, every element of this amps is of employee type. That's why I defined this as employee. And here, what I will do, system.out.println. Here, I will print E. So E is an employee object. What will happen here on this line, 59, it will use the toString method of the employee. Here I'm trying to print an employee object. Okay, E is an employee object. But println requires a string. When I use an employee object or when I use an object, any object, it automatically uses the toString method. It calls a toString method for the employee object. It will get this string and return that string. And I will have a string from here instead of E. It will be very similar. This will be very similar to, or the exactly same as E dot to string. Okay. Although I write it like this, in reality, Java automatically converts it to that and run the toString method for that employee object. It gets a string representation of the object and prints that string representation. Now it is, we have to call this print employees in our program. Here we have read employees, print employees. And let's copy this here, semicolon, and let's delete the rest. That's okay. Now let's run this program. Luckily, at the first time, it ran correct. Okay, here I see my employees. Okay, as you see, they are nicely aligned because I used formatting. If I, instead of using this type of string formatting, if I just, for example, do something else, instead of doing this return, if I just write, for example, let's go here and modify this. And instead of returning this, if I return just those fields concatenated to each other. Return fname plus a space between them plus. And here, let's take these things, control C, modify this, comma with that. And semicolon at the end. I can have this. Let's go there, run this program again. I will have this output, okay? As you see, this output is not readable at all. If I display many data, many employee data. Therefore, usually when I write programs, I prefer not to just put the data, concatenate the data like this, but have a much, to my opinion, better version of it like this. And when I run this, I have now if I print multiple data, multiple objects, this format is a lot easier to read. Okay. I will finish my lecture here. Do you have any questions about these? Did you understand how I built my attributes, my constructor methods, my mutator methods, my accessor methods, and on at the end, of course, this toString. Before finishing, I want to do one more thing. What is wrong here? It says there is some error here, but oh, player. Of course, this is employer up. We forgot to delete the team and player class inside the employee. Up. Okay, now it's better. Now, what I will do, I will just add one more thing. I will assume that then we came to year 2022. So what will happen? The number of work years of each employee will be increased by one. Okay. When we move to next year, in our data, these values, one will become two, eight will become nine, etc. So the years, the work years will be increased by one. So what I will do, I will write something to increase the work years in the employees array list. Let's this increase work years. Increase W years. Okay. My method name will be increase work years. After increasing work years, I will print again. Okay. So I will have this printed again. Now I will write my increase work years. It will be similar to this one. Let's copy this. Now it will be increase W years. It gets an array list of employees. Here to increase VW years method, I give the employees array list as I'm giving it to print employees. Therefore, here it doesn't return anything. What it will do, it will modify the elements. Okay. It will in each employee object inside the array list, it will change the work years by one. So how we will do that? Let's try this method. I will get each employee in the amps array list as E. How do I change the work years? I will use the mutator method for work years, okay? The way of changing an attribute of an object is to use a mutator method. So I only can change the work year of an employee object by using the mutator method set W years. But in order to change it, in order to increase it by one, I have to get it first and add one and then set it. So in order to get, I have to use an accessor method, okay? I will use accessor method get W years to get the number of work years. In my expression, I will add one to it and then I will use set W years. So here in my application, what I will do, I'm getting each object in amps to E. How do I get the employee, this employee's E's workers? Get W years gives me the number of work years. Plus one is the new one. So what I will do, E dot set W years, I will give this as parameter, okay? Set W years is the mutator method for employee object. It gets a value and it modifies the attributes, the related attribute to that value. So I'm calling here the employee objects set W years, set W years method. And as parameter, I'm first getting the same employee objects work years. Add one, I have here an arithmetic expression. This expression will get, first of all, the number of work years from the object. Add one to it. I have a new number here. And this new number will be replaced in the same object as the W years attribute. Okay. So this is how I will do it. Let's run this program and see what will happen. Here I have my employees. Let's expand this. Nicholas James was working for 1 year. Now Nicholas James is now working for 2 years. Jane Walsh was working for 4 years before. Now Jane Walsh has 5. Okay. Is this understood?
Yeah.
This is critical. Okay. This part is quite critical. I can write the same loop in another way. This is one way. What I will do, I will just comment this out, or I will just copy this, Control C, Control B. This is one way of doing it. I will show another way of doing it so that you will have a better understanding of array lists. How do I access array list elements? I generate indexes. Index start from zero. As long as j is less than, what is the number of elements in an array list? We get it by size method, okay? Size method gives us the number of elements in an array list, and we increase j by 1. Here, we will get, we don't now have any E, but instead, how do we get an object from array list? Amps get J, okay? Here, I'm getting, of course, this is more simple, but sometimes you may be forced to write it this way for some reasons. Anyway, here, what I'm doing, I'm getting the jth object, the object with index J from the amps array list using this get J. This is now an employee object, okay? Amps is an array list of employee objects. Amps.get J will get one object from the array list. Since the array list is an employee contains employee objects, I'm getting one object from here, from the employee amps array list. I get the years, work years of that object. I add one to it to find the new work years for that object. And now I have to set it using the set W years. But what is the object? It is the object with the jth index. Do you understand this statement? It may seem a little bit confusing, but if you go step by step, you will understand. Amps is an array list. In order to get an element from array list, we use get method with the index. Index is J. So this is one employee object from the array list. for the to get the work years of that, I use the get W years of the employee class. I now get the workers of the jth employee object in the amps array list. I add one to it and I want to modify it. So I modify the same objects, years, work years by set W years. And I give this arithmetic expression as parameter. If you look to the array list explanations, we see that the set method is used, replaces the element with the specified index position in the array list. So set is used. We use the index. We are not using the set here. This set is the changing the array list element. We are not changing the array list element here. We are changing one attribute of the object in the array list. It is not changing. I'm taking it back. We will not use this array list. We are not changing the array list element. We just change an attribute in the array list. So we are not changing the whole object. Okay. We are changing just one attribute in the same object. So here we have the object here. We have the same object. Inside the same object, we only change the work years. That's why we are using the set W years of the employee employee class. We are not using the set method of the array list class. Okay. Probably I have confused you a little bit, but anyway, forget the last few things. Go back to here. We are getting an object. We are getting the workers of that object. We increment by one. We get a new number. And in the same object, the jth object, we change the workers. And we have the result. Now let's run this program once more. And we will see that it runs correctly with this new format, with this new program. Jane Walsh had 4. Now it has 5. And Catherine Robertson was 11. Is 11 now? It was 10 before. Okay, this is the end of my lecture for today. Any questions related with classes and even array lists or reading from files? Here we have combining many things. We have array lists. We have objects. Okay, we are creating here objects. We are putting these objects to array lists, of course, to amps. Let's fix the comments. Create an employee instance or employee object. Add employee object to amps array list. I will fix this. Do you want me to put this employee program to LMS?
Yeah.
Okay, I will put it there. So I will put 3 files, employee.java, the employee class, employee app, and then also the employee.txt, the text file as well. I will put these 3 files to LMS. Let's go here. Okay. I will just modify, turn editing on. I will just do it right away. And in the meantime, if you have any questions, please ask your questions.
I have.